I see people are still logging in, and that's fine. We're going to get go ahead and get started. I want to preface this evening's little session with five things that you should have on your homepage of your website. And I'm drawing these conclusions from this book, Contractor Marketing Simplified. And on your homepage, there are five key things or key elements that you should have in order to engage with the people who check out your site, as well as conversion is what you're after, right? You want people to come to your website and do their research, do their homework, and eventually you want them to not only know you and like you, but ultimately trust you, which will lead to a sale. Thank you, Avis. Schnapps. I haven't checked out your store yet, but thanks. I appreciate you saying that. And hopefully, I'm trying to remember if you are up here in the Northwest. It seems like I got a direct message from you recently, and currently we're working with a few people in the Northwest trying to get a Instagram meetup in Seattle going. But anyway, let's get on with the five things you need on your homepage. So the first thing, obviously, is your phone number. Lots of people will Google you and Google your website and try to find out just simply what your number is because they want to call you. So don't ever send someone to your website and not give them what they're looking for. And one of the main things they're looking for is your phone number. So make that paramount. Make it easy for them to find. Make it easy for them to call you. If New York, okay, I was way off on that one. Sorry about that. But anyway, Connecticut, great to have you guys here. So if you are optimizing your website for mobile, which you should be, because the majority of people checking you out or looking you up are going to be on their mobile phone, then make sure that you have a clickable phone number on your website. And what I mean by that is when somebody goes to call you, you don't want to say, okay, here's my phone number. Now go over to your phone app and try and remember what it was, enter the area code, enter the phone number and all that. What you want to do is... When we locking up round two, we're going to do it, brother. We're going to do it. We're going to do it soon. But what you want is a clickable phone number so that when they press with their finger, it says call now. That's what you want to make sure you have. So anyway, upper right-hand corner is where I recommend that you put your phone number on your website. And then the second thing you want to have on your homepage is a high-quality image. A high definition image of your best work. Make sure that that's there on your homepage. Maybe that's a beautiful kitchen, maybe a backyard deck, maybe one of the custom homes that you've built. And something that we've started doing is putting a moving video in the background of your main image at the top of your website. And that's powerful. So let's just imagine taking a time-lapse video of some of your best work and putting it in the background that's playing automatically when somebody lands on your website with a couple of simple calls to action or one call to action right in the middle of that. It's a beautiful and powerful example. I'm working on a website right now for a contractor, and when we get it done, I'll show you because it's going to be really awesome to have that. But if you don't have video or if you don't have a time-lapse video or anything like that, that's okay. Make sure that it is a high-definition, high-quality image of your best work. The third thing you want on your homepage is a call to action. Before somebody scrolls or presses or goes anywhere, you want to lead them, first of all, to that clear call to action. Maybe it's learn more or read our reviews or give us a call, you know, something that you are leading them to. Make that pretty clear right away on your homepage. The fourth thing is a menu bar. display a nice menu bar for easy navigation to other important areas of your website. And then the fifth thing is compelling content. People come to your website to do their research. They come there to find out more about you, and eventually you want to lead them to trust you. And the best way to help someone trust you is to provide content that is valuable, that answers their questions, content that gives solutions to the problems that they came there with in their minds. So if somebody lands on your website, they have these questions in their minds. They have these problems that they're dealing with. And if you are the one that's able to lead them down a pathway to find resolution to those problems on your website, they're going to trust you. They're going to like you for that. They're going to appreciate that. And eventually they'll want to do business with you. That's what you want your website to do. Not just feature you, not just how awesome you are, but you want to help them get what they're looking for. Anthony, welcome. Good to see you, brother. I'm glad you're here tonight. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Matt's Total Painting, what's a basic cost? Costs for websites range. We charge $3,500 for setup and $97 a month to maintain it. And then we have another marketing package that we add on top of that. That's what we charge. We're not the cheapest, but we don't want to be because we provide a high-end service. But there's a whole host of ranges. And you know, if you've been in business long, you probably have people calling you every day to with the, you know, promoting their services. All right, real quickly, I want to go over the top seven web pages or pages you should have on your website. Then we're going to take a look at two websites that they sent them in and said, Martin, would you look at them? So the top seven pages are your home page. Obviously, that's the most important page of your website. Turnaround. You mean like how long does it take to get it set up? Within 30 days? The biggest bottleneck in website building is getting information back from the client. Great saying. God bless you, man. Johnny, as far as does that include SEO, no, the first price I mentioned doesn't. The second price, $297 a month, is a total like website, local SEO, and online reputation package. That's the second package. And then it goes up from there where we do Facebook ads and Google ads, but that's another package on top. The About page is the second page that you should have on your website. And the About page is unarguably one of the most important pages that you should have on your website. Yeah, Elite Design, I know. SEO with, I don't know much about how well SEO works with Squarespace. I just know it works really well with WordPress. The About page is one of the most, if not the most, clicked on tabs in the menu bar. Why? Because someone comes to your website and they're like, who is this guy anyway? You know, I want to learn. I want to know who they are, see who kind of their backstory and if they can really answer my questions. So they click on the About. Now, one thing I've been doing is putting the About content on the homepage down a ways and then linking the About tab to that content. So that works as well. You just want to make sure that you have a place where you feature who you are, what you do, and how you can supply their needs. I'm reading these questions. Faithful Contractor, I'm glad you're here. We're going to go over your website in just a little bit. Five different people have submitted their websites to me to take a look at. We're going to do two tonight if we have time. No, we're going to do them. But anyway, Faithful Contracting, stay here because we're going to go over your website in a little bit. And if you don't have time tonight, I'm attempting to record this entire thing, so I'll be able to have a replay of it. How much are most websites? $3,500 and up. How long should your About page be? As long as it takes. Give give good quality content that explains your story in a way that answers their questions. Yeah. All right. The third page you should have on your website is your portfolio, or a gallery, or a place where people can go to see some of the work that you've been doing. And there's a couple different ways you can do that. One, you can have a gallery or portfolio, or two, you can take your Instagram feed and embed it in your page. And if you're updating your Instagram feed every day with high quality pictures of your work, it's getting updated on your website at the same time. John, good point. Good content above the fold, and then as you scroll down, have more information down below. The fourth page is your contact page. Give customers the basic information that they need to contact you. The fifth page is your reputation page, a place that you can display your reviews, your testimonials, featuring your reputation, right? That's something that we want to know. Like, what are other people saying about you? We should be able to go on Google and Yelp and Home Advisor, or maybe not there, but like Houzz and different places and read reviews. But we also want to come to your website and see what other people have had to say about your website, or about you, actually, about your work. The blog, that's your sixth page. The blog should feature articles answering a question from your ideal client or the dreams that they have in their minds. So that's what you want your blog to do, is you want your blog to answer those questions they have in their minds, or help them dream the dreams that they have in their minds. So I see Giuliano's on here, Amanda, right? And you're an interior designer. You might want to think about blogging in a way that creates dreams in their minds, as well as answer questions. If I'm a remodeler, taking people's bathrooms, I not only want to create those dreams, but I want to answer their questions, you know? So there's a lot of things you can do with your blog. How many photos do you recommend? Same for reviews, like, is there a good amount? Spoiler alert, I was listening to Ryan's podcast today. It's coming out in a couple weeks, RJT Carpentry and Tile, and he has been obsessive about getting reviews for the past 7 years, and he has almost 100 reviews online. I bet if you asked him, is that enough? He would say, I'll take more. You know, reviews are important. They're important for building trust in people's minds, and they're also important for telling Google regularly that you're a serious businessman or woman, and you are getting good reviews. You know what I'm saying? As far as how many photos, my personal opinion is that quality is better than quantity. So get high definition, high quality photos and be putting them on regularly as you complete your projects. So if you're just getting started, you're only going to have a few images, and that's fine. But as you do your projects, then get more high quality images and add them to your site on an ongoing basis. The last page is your frequently asked questions page. This is something I rarely see people do, but yet I highly encourage it. I'm coming to your website with questions in my mind, and if you can help me answer my questions without me ever needing to pick up the phone, I like you. You know what I'm saying? I trust you. If you're answering my questions before we ever meet in person, boom. Deal done. So think about that. What are the top questions you get asked all the time? You're answering them over and over again. Put them on your website. Create a frequently asked questions page, an FAQ page, and put them on there. Okay? So the top seven pages, your home page, your about page, your portfolio, your contact, reputation page, your blog page, and your frequently asked questions page. All right, that's an excellent question, Giuliano. I'm going to actually go to my computer now and pull up Faithful Contracting's website, and then an electrician's website. Both of these people sent me direct messages and said, hey, would you go over my website? We're just going to do it real quickly. We won't go into depth. We're just going to take a look at it and see how they line up with the what I just read to you. Okay, so I'm going to flip the camera around. And here we have Faithful Contracting's website. Let me move this just a little bit. And you guys can all hear me okay, right? Obviously, because I've been talking now for 15 minutes, and I assume everybody can hear. So the first thing I'm looking at is that high definition image. Right here, we have this picture, and it says, like, when I hover over it, it says almost 600 followers, planning on doing another t-shirt giveaway that I haven't done. I'm not sure why that's showing up, but I wonder if it's not pulling from Instagram. But anyway, what I would recommend is putting this entire section, this white is one picture, one image of your best work. Fill up this entire space with an image. And then right in the middle, put like maybe three words, like looking for, I don't know, high-end custom contractor or something like that. And then have a button that's a call to action, like learn more or give us a call or contact us today. You know, something like that is what I would recommend on your homepage. And that's all there is. So we're not going to go down the screen and see if there's anything else. The about page is very nice. You have these nice pictures of your family and then all of this text, which I like because it tells me about you and it tells me about your family and what, you know, what all you guys do and why you named your business Faithful Contracting. I like that too, because I honestly had that question in my mind. I thought, why did you name your business Faithful Contracting? And you answered my question right here. So kudos to you. Now, these Instagram and Facebook links, they're up here in the menu bar, but they link out to off of your website. So in other words, when I click on Instagram, it opens your Instagram. And when I click on Facebook, it opens Facebook to your page, which is good, but I would put those links up here, little buttons, like a little Instagram icon and a little Facebook icon. In other words, if I say, I want to go see if they're on Facebook, I can click that. But your website menu bar should keep people on your website. So what you can do is you can put, instead of Instagram, you could put a like gallery or portfolio tab, and then it open up the page and embed your Instagram feed right here, and it keeps them on your website that way. Contact page, very simple, basic, very nice. This is nice. This lets people contact you. That's what the contact page is for. The projects tab has a big drop down with lots of different projects, which is cool. So Walnut Wine Room, click on that. There it is. There's the images. There's the Walnut Wine Room. That's nice. I don't really have much to say about that other than it looks good. Testimonials, I recommend this. I recommend that you have an Our Reputation or Testimonials page, and you do, which is great. The only thing I might suggest that might help, this almost looks like it's one testimonial, one like newspaper article. So if there was a way you could separate these out and make them separate, it might be easier to read. That's the only thing I'm suggesting there. So at least you have them though. That's good. Now, do you guys notice on the homepage one thing that's missing? This is extremely important. Oh, there it is right there. I didn't even see that, the phone number. But you want your phone number to be front and center on your website. And we usually put it right up here on the right-hand side of the menu bar. And you want it to be bold. You want it to be easy to find. You want people to find it right away. When I land on a website for the first time and I'm looking for your phone number, that's, I want it to be easy to find. And then secondly, I want it to be click to call so that I can call you really, really easy. Now, I want to see if this is mobile responsive. And the way I do that is I drag the screen all the way down as small as it'll go. And if it collapses and changes, it's mobile responsive. Now, this website was built on Wix, so it might be mobile, like if I pulled it up on my phone, but it's just not mobile responsive. And it's, you know, because it's not adjusting automatically on my computer. So I don't know if it's, I guess I could ask you. You can let us know in the comments if it's mobile, like on the phone. I don't want to try pulling it up or I'll have to end the Instagram Live that's happening right now. All right. So there you have it. That's Faithful Contracting website. I hope what I've went over has been helpful and maybe you've been able to think of some things that can be done to improve it. The next website we're going to look at is davidcooperelectric.com. The first thing I want to know is, like I said, the phone number and the call to action. So there's his phone number right here, which is in the middle of the menu bar, which is fine. I usually put it on the right-hand side, but at least it's up here and highly visible. And then he also has it up here above his logo, two places above the fold, which is good. I don't know that this information up here needs to be here. Personally, I would probably cut off this website at that white line right there and this be the menu bar and put my phone number right here and then also down here in the footer, which it is. Isn't that awesome? The second thing I was thinking about this website is notice the branding. Notice the colors. Notice how it all kind of flows. The branding and the colors, you can tell that there's been some thought put into this as far as consistency, branding consistency and things like that. So that's a good job. And then as we roll down, you can see, by the way, above the fold means everything you can see before you scroll. You're welcome. You're welcome for that, Faithful Contracting. I was just reading. I haven't been reading all the comments, but I just every now and then look at it. So as I scroll down, I can see he's got three different sections here. Read, you know, and you can learn more about. So residential electrician, commercial, and industrial with a little blurb about what each one of those means. And then you can read more if you want. And then his latest work. Isn't that neat? Kind of tells about some of his latest projects, who we are. Remember how the about is some of the most important information that you're going to provide on your website. If I had any encouragement or, changes to offer, it would be to make this a little bit more personal. Now, I don't know who this company is. They might be a corporation with 300 employees. And David Cooper isn't even involved anymore. I don't really know, but I still want it to be personal. I still want to feel like when I come here that these are real people with real lives, with a family and a background. So think about that when you're writing your, you're on here. Awesome. I'm glad. Glad if you have any answers as I come up with these questions, let me know. I appreciate that, David. But anyway, try to make it a little bit more personal. Like, let's go to your about page. Let's just do that. So we pull up the about page, who we are, what we do. I like that person. I mean, that's awesome. David, is this a picture of you and your dad? Or you and your son, I want this to be you. When I come here and see who we are, I want to know that's you. That's who I'm going to be dealing with if I pick up the phone and call. So you're saying, no, it's not. And I kind of wondered because it looks like a stock image to me. But I wasn't going to say it's a stock image because you might just, you might have had a professional photographer come and take that picture. And if you did, that'd be awesome. But I want to know who you guys are. So you guys are fully licensed and insured, and you offer guarantees. You were established in 1992, the Cooper family, in the Merrimack Valley, Boston areas. Okay, that's all great to know. No matter how small the job may be, you're glad to do it. You take pride in doing it. That's great. That's awesome. I just want to see, is there any way we can make this just a little more personal? And if not, that's fine, but just give that some thought. When we were looking at Faithful Contracting's about page, you'll notice that they include pictures of their family and where they got the Faithful Contracting name and what that means for the customers. So when you're thinking of the about page, you want to think about the questions that are going on in the minds of people who are coming. So they're coming to your website for a reason, and they're clicking on your about page for a reason. So you want to answer those questions like, okay, this is who we are, this is our background, and what that means for you is this. Because of our background and because of our family or whatever, this is the kind of service you're going to get. So those are just some things to think about when you're writing your about page. Your mission, your service, and your promise. All right. So we go on to the services page. It lists your services with a quote form. And then your contact page is here. And I like how it has that map. I think that's a good touch, as well as your information here. So that's awesome. Now, it is mobile responsive. I checked that earlier. Let's drag this to the side. Let's go to the home page. Okay. Notice how everything shifted and it's now in a vertical line. And as you come down, like if you're scrolling on your phone, coming down here, you're going to see, everything adjusted. All right. That's awesome. Now I'm trying to think if there's anything else. I guess I might ask this. Do you have any reviews? Do you have any happy customers? Anybody that would be willing to give you a review or a testimonial? All right, here's one. Okay. There's two. And they flip through right here. And that's good. It's on your homepage. If I'm scrolling down, I might see that. But as I'm researching, I'm thinking, oh yeah, here's a tab up here. Maybe you want to put a tab up here that shows your reviews or your testimonials. That'd be something for you to think about too. Another thing you might want to think about adding is frequently asked questions page. So those are just some things. Overall, this is a very nice website, and I really don't have a lot that I would do differently. I mean, if it's working, then keep using it by all means. I just wanted to give you a little bit of thoughts as to what I saw. One thing you might try sometime is changing the button. Like this says, learn more. Maybe try changing it to call now and see if you get any, test it for a month and see if anything changes. You can do that. You can test different things and see if it makes any difference. But overall, very nice website. But would you know how to make it more flexible like the website you're reviewing now? Faithful Contract, I'm not sure. I'm not familiar with the Wix platform. We use WordPress for our websites, and so I'm not sure. I don't know how to say that. Scooped. You meant David Cooper. All right, guys. That has been a brief overview of two websites, things that are looking really nice about them, and a few tips and ideas of things you could do to improve them. Hopefully that's been helpful. I have recorded this, so if you would like to watch the recording, send me a message, and also I'll try and get it put on my YouTube channel or somewhere like that so that you'll have access to it. Do you rebuild or make company? If that question was for me, yes, that's what we do. We do contractor websites and marketing for contractors. Amanda, have a good night. I'm so glad you guys were here. I'm thinking of doing this more often. In fact, I have three more websites we need to review. So possibly this week I'll do more of these.